Hello, this is Kalotron, please, and welcome back to another Minecraft tutorial. Today, guys, I'll be showing you all how to make this epic infinite villager breeder, which you can use to get awesome trades and power your iron golem farm. So, if you like the sound of that, please make sure to drop a like on the video, and if you really enjoy it, please make sure to subscribe. But anyway, let's get into this. So, this infinite villager breeder, basically, these two villagers up here, the farmer and any other villager, they breed by throwing carrots into each other. The village that the farmer harvests, and they can only throw the carrots when it's considered a village. And this third villager down here, with all the villagers, makes this entire structure count as a village, so that makes them able to breed. And then this system also carries them in water, the baby villagers, down into this collection pod, where they will grow up into full-sized villagers like we have here. So, let's get straight in to how to make this. So, you want to start off by creating a 9x9 ring of glass around the area. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And the next step you're going to do is build this block up 6 more blocks so it turns into a 7 high ring of glass. So I'll go ahead and come back when I've done that. Okay, and now after you've done that, you should see that this glass is now 7 high. And it's a 9x9 area. It should look a bit like this. Then the next step you're going to want to do is take some dirt and fill in most of this space. So you want to take a 7x2x9 block of dirt here, basically filling in all of this space, just like this. So I'll fill it in and I can show the next step. So yeah, just literally fill all of this in. And then you can move on to the next step. So when you've done that, you just want to take out 3 bits of glowstone and about 12 oak doors. And you want to just take out this block here, the center block, and another block like there. And then you just place doors all in this area. So place about 14 doors and 3 glowstone in this area. Then you're going to want to get a villager, any old one, and just place him in there. Which you'll probably just find one from a village and get him in there in survival mode. But in creative, we can literally just spawn him in. And the next step is, on top of all of this, you literally just want to build a layer of glass to section this area off from the section above. So once you've done that, you just want to take your dirt here and go around the edge like this, just a bit like that. So we have an L shape where it hits both of the corners like that. Then in the center, you want to build up the same thing, just like you want to build up the same thing, 3 blocks high. And yeah, in the center, you're basically having a 3 high 5x5 cube of dirt. So I'm just going to fill that in and I'll be back in 1 second. Okay, and when you've done that, you want to make sure there's a 1 block hole right in the center of the top, and that's where your water is going to be for all your crops, as you can see here. So you want to leave a space for that in the center. Then the next step is to get out the water. So you want to put 1 water bucket at the back here, and you should see that flows right down into the corner like that perfectly, just going over the edges, and place your next water right in the center there. Then you're going to want to take out your hoe and till all of this land and then plant your carrots on top of it. So let's do that quickly, just hoeing all the ground, then take out your carrots and place them on the top of here all the way along until we've just about finished. Then you can take a lily pad, or you can use a carpet in survival and just put it right on top of the water. Then after that, You're going to want to get out our trap doors from our inventory here and place them along the sides like so. Just face them into the wall, and at the end I'll show you what it looks like. You should just be able to flap down all the trap doors and see what they should look like. So you see, flap them all down and you will see that. So, if a baby runs your force into this corner, you'll just see they'll go along the edge, he'll be moved by these trapdoors, and end up down in this space right here, and it'll be the same for the other way around. And these trapdoors also mean that the regular villagers can't really fall in there. But just to make sure, we need to add another ring of glass around this top area, just so they don't fall in. So, we're going to add that ring around, just like this, above blocks where the trap doors are, and then comes the part that might be hard in survival. We're going in this farm area, we're going to want a brown coat villager and any other villager. So there's our any other villager, our blacksmith, and now we also want a farmer. So we may have to give this a few attempts, so let me just cycle through these guys until I have found a brown coat villager. Okay? And now that you've got your brown coat villager here in, and your any other villager, we're going to want to just stick a roof on this farm, just so, you know, nothing can get in and nothing can get out. So we're just going to place a roof of glass on here and add in some trapdoors in a second. So we've added in all our glass. Now in the corners and the centre, we're going to add a bit of glowstone, so nothing spawns right here and kills the villagers. And the final step here is to add in the collection chamber, where we'll be able to send off the new villagers to somewhere else. So as you can see here, it's just a chamber with a dispenser leading out, which will fire them off in the mine. So let's just show you how to build that collection chamber quickly. So we're going to want to punch away this block right here, and we're going to take out a sign, just and place a block out just like that to stop the water flowing out. My next step is to like make a tube essentially for the baby villager to fall into, so he can be collected in a second. So we've done that all nicely. So the villagers will fall into this section right here, and then we're going to want to bring out a dispenser and some rails, as well as a button and redstone. So we want to place in our dispenser right here, and we want to just place up a few blocks going along with a power rail right next to this dispenser and two rails leading out from it. And next to that, you want to place a block up next to the powered rail, and a block just like this behind the dispenser. Now the block behind the dispenser, you're going to want to put redstone dust on, and this block here on either side, you can stick a button, and this will power the powered rail and the dispenser at the same time, meaning that your villager gets picked up in his minecart and gets launched off to wherever you need him to go. And really, that's about it for this farm. It's really simple. The only expense really you're making is your glass, because you can always get so much dirt. But yeah, this is a really simple farm to get you loads of villagers for all of your villager needs, like trading and iron farms. But guys, this has been the video. If you've enjoyed learning how to make this super cool and super simple device, then please make sure to leave a like on the video. And if you really enjoyed, please make sure to subscribe. Thanks for watching. This has been Caleb Tron Plays. I'll see you all in the next video. Goodbye!